Hi, I'm Mike Capelli, EST of the Northeast Regional Council of Carpenters. We, in partnership with the Carpenter Contractor Trust, are committed to raising awareness about the New Jersey Hall of Fame Mobile History Museum. That is why we're proud to support this special program produced by Caucus Educational Corporation, dedicated to the New Jersey Hall of Fame.
Funding for this edition of One on One with Steve Adubato has been provided by Barnabas Health, Life is Better Healthy. Cone Resnick, providing accounting, tax, and advisory services for more than 90 years. The New Jersey Education Association, working for great public schools for every child. PSE&G, committed to improving New Jersey's economy and strengthening its communities. Johnson & Johnson, Horizon Blue Cross Blue Shield of New Jersey. And by the Carpenter Contractor Trust, New York, New Jersey, the Construction Network.
This is One on One.
When you first heard that they were doing Charlie Rose and Gayle King, didn't you go, what?
People like laughing at others, so I don't mind if the other is me.
See, you go right into the character. That's what it is.
I'm bringing families together a half an hour each week. Man, I'm doing something special.
And so I do feel successful.
Hi, Steve Adubato on location at the Newark Museum for the 6th annual New Jersey Hall of Fame induction ceremony. Tonight was a very special night. You're about to meet the 2013 class of the New Jersey Hall of Fame. People in the arts, culture, the humanities, people who have given so much, in the sports field as well. These are people you recognize, you know, but you're not so sure what makes them so special. Well, tonight, you're gonna see why the New Jersey Hall of Fame recognizes them as the best, the brightest, the people who have given so much to the state of New Jersey. The New Jersey Hall of Fame. And one of the many great sponsors, the generous sponsors of the New Jersey Hall of Fame is Barnabas Health. Barry, you and your team are here, Barry Ostrowski. Lots of great causes. Why this one?
Because we're a New Jersey company built with New Jersey people, physicians, nurses, and clinicians, and we treat people from New Jersey. We're very proud of our state, and this is a way to educate people throughout the state about how great New Jersey is. And we look forward to the Mobile Hall of Fame going to schools and other organizations so people can learn about the great people that have built this state.
Kevin McCabe, you guys are one of the main sponsors of this great event. Why?
Well, we were a major sponsor of the Mobile Museum, not only in our equity.
Tell folks what that is.
Well, what we did, the Mobile Museum is wonderful. What we literally did is we got a call from Steve Edwards 18 months ago.
The head of the Hall of Fame.
Head of the Hall of Fame and the foundation, and asked if we would be a part of the equity in terms of helping to deconstruct the truck and help build it, which we did and along with our contractor. And through this endeavor, what we discovered is we wanted to be more than that. We wanted to put in some of our own equity in terms of resources. And we became a prime sponsor because of the educational component is what the carpenters and contractors believe, and it really speaks to our value system.
Tony Ciccatello is not only a successful executive in the field of advertising, public relations, communications, but in a previous life, worked with, what was that governor's name?
It was Tom Cade.
Tom Cade's being inducted tonight. What does that mean to you?
I think it's one of the nicest things that I think could have happened to him because he was so New Jersey. Everybody thinks the Canes, he might have been born in New York, but he was a New Jersey guy through and through. And people don't know, he represented Essex County and went all the way into Newark.
In the state legislature.
When he was a representative, he represented Newark all the way out to the suburbs. So his heart is Newark, and his heart is also New Jersey as a whole. I mean, it's a wonderful, wonderful attribution to him.
We're here tonight to honor a long overdue record of Tom Cade, both as the 9/11 leader, and he really did get us through understanding 9/11, and the education governor. And he has certainly done a good deal to get us through. You'll notice we do a column, by the way, in a ledger, and you notice that if an education problem comes up, I defer to Tom. And So tonight I defer to Tom Kane because he is a Hall of Famer and well-deserved.
One of the most extraordinary inductees to the 2013 New Jersey Hall of Fame is Governor Tom Kane. Governor, you've been honored by a lot of organizations, a lot of folks. What does this Hall of Fame mean to you?
This is New Jersey. This is New Jersey. When you get honored by the Hall of Fame, and it's your own state, and you're honored with a bunch of extraordinary people, it's very, very special.
Governor, what is it about our state that you think the rest of the country just doesn't get?
They don't get our diversity. They don't get our energy. They don't get anything. Nobody understands New Jersey, unless you're really from New Jersey. A guy from General Electric told me once, it's a very hard state to move into, but it's the most impossible state to get anybody to move out of. Because once you're here, you love it.
Juetta is an entrepreneur, a businesswoman, an author, a motivational speaker. There are so many aspects of her. In addition, she's a mother, a devoted wife, sister, daughter, and friend. But what I most admire about her is that all of that hard work she put in, and I saw it firsthand, all of those runs and workouts and the accolades she achieved as a result, she didn't take that just for her own personal pursuits and personal advancement. She wanted to give back to her community through the Juetta Clark Diggs Sports Foundation. And that's something that's very special to me.
Juetta, let me ask you, you're being inducted in the 2013 New Jersey Hall of Fame class. What does that mean to you?
I'm very excited to be inducted. I've been in the other Hall of Fames, but this is special because New Jersey's voted for me, and I'm just happy to be in this class this year.
Let folks know who may not know just some of your accomplishments athletically.
Oh, wow, Steve. Four-time Olympian, a USA Track and Field Hall of Famer, a world record holder, a college graduate, and New Jersey through and through.
We're here with the great Jerry Cooney, who's part of this night. Jerry, what's your connection to tonight?
You know, there's a great guy, Jersey Joe Walcott, was one of the best fighters in his time and in any time. And he's being inducted tonight, and I'm really glad I'm getting the opportunity to come in and talk a little bit about him.
Jerry, this state of New Jersey you know well. Connected to boxing, right? Great boxing history.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, great fighters come from New Jersey. Through the century.
And Jersey Joe, for those who really don't know much about Jersey Joe Walcott, tell folks.
Jersey Joe Walcott took him five tries to become the heavyweight champion of the world. He fought Rocky Marciano twice, Ezra Charles four times, Joe Louis. It took him 17 years to get a crack at the title with 58 fights. I mean, you know, come on. Most guys, 3 or 4 years, you're fighting for the championship. It took him 58 fights. And he got a shot with Joe Louis. And part of it was because of the, you know, back in those days. And part of it was because he was so good, nobody wanted to risk losing to him.
I am dark and you are light.
You are blind as a bat, then. I have sight. Side by side, you are my amigo.
Living in perfect harmony.
We're talking salt and pepper. Oh. Sammy and Dean. Oh. Stevie and me are Peachy King.
You are white.
You are black. And who cares? Who cares, baby?
I'm here to talk about my friend Joe Piscopo, the artist. First, the artist. As we saw that sketch on Saturday Night Live, we all kind of remember where we were at that time, because it was such groundbreaking stuff in the 80s. When Joe came out with Eddie Murphy and did that, it was an incredible thing what he did. Because no one talked about that back then, Joe doing Frank and Eddie doing Stevie. And they broke such new ground back then. Joe is not only a wonderful comedian, he's a comic, he's an actor, he's a writer. He does his one-man show. Joe is really a great artist. And a lot of times, because of the way he is, he's so humble and he has so much humility. Sometimes, you know, some people take it as, well, you know, he's Joe Piscopo, he's good, but Joe is really great. Sometimes the people who get into their heads and they're so difficult, they are the geniuses, but that's wrong. You could be a real nice guy and still be a great artist too. And that's Joe Piscopo, the artist. And I want to say about Joe the man, and that's why I'm really here. Not only do I respect him as an artist, I respect him as a man. Because when someone needs something, when Sandy hit New Jersey, Joe was there. When people need to raise money for someone who's sick, for some food bank, for someone caring, especially in New Jersey, Joe is always there.
And I know I'm here. I wrote the jokes 20 years ago. What can I tell you, folks? I wrote a lot of the jokes. Honestly, some of the jokes in New Jersey write themselves. Thank you very much. It's just like, you can't, but I did write the line, "What exit, Lieutenant Governor?" I hope you don't mind, and that was great. But it's especially, I have to acknowledge some people here today. You know, Anthony Pope, my attorney, my dear friend. Anthony, thank you, man. You're the best friend a guy could have. Always watching my back. I appreciate that. My son, my number one son, Joey, is here. In New Jersey, I have a child at every exit, and he's my number one right there. So I got exit 145 right there. Great guy. I love you, Joey, heart and soul. And thank you. And I have to tell you, I have to step right down here. You can hear me. My 9-year-old daughter, Olivia, is here, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, and you're not going to school tomorrow. Don't worry about it. That's great. You can stay home. So, I think Joe Standish, thank you for helping in on the board of directors of the Boys and Girls Club, doing such a great job and being the host here. We appreciate it. And Louis, we love you guys that are here. But the reason why it's so moving to me to be here is because my mother and my father were brought up in this great city. My father was brought up in Mount Prospect Avenue. And my father always told me the crossroads of the world were Broad and Market Street in Newark. I remember hearing that. To my pop, that was it, man. It was Newark, New Jersey. And he, you know, went from Newark. They made fun of him with his Italian accent, but he took that Jersey attitude and he went to school and he skipped grades and he went on to represent, as an attorney, to represent the non-English speaking blue collar laborers that his father was. That's the Jersey spirit, you know? And I have to remember and acknowledge my father. He is such a strong presence in my life and such a Newark guy, you know? But I'm really moved tonight because my mother's here tonight. And my mother was born on East Kinney Street, right up the road here, right off of Broad and Mulberry, right up there, East Kinney. Now, Mom is like, she's the boss of the family, and she is the backbone of the family. And I have to tell you, to be up here with all this great talent, Steve Adubato, my dear friend, you know that, and Bart Oates and Steve Edwards, you do such a great job here, and Nikki Greco's in the house, all my dear friends. It is so special for me to be here to see my mother receive this. And I am eternally grateful to you, because this is better than the Academy Awards. This is about Jersey, baby. This is about my mom from East Kinney Street, a family of 10 from Newark, New Jersey. Coming here, to come full circle like this with my mom in the audience is what the Hall of Fame stands for. And tonight, it's about everything that I live for in the state.
I tell you, New Jersey has a lot to be proud of in Bobby Brown. She could have easily insisted on making her home in New York City closer to the glitz, glamour, and everything that the beauty industry brings you. But she chose instead to be a Montclair mom with an incredible family. You see her in the local stores, rarely wearing makeup, usually with her hair up in a ponytail, just being Bobby, because New Jersey is really where she wants to be. Some who may not know Bobby very well, and you should Google the hell out of her because there's a lot to know. For being such a massive, massive, massive success in the cosmetic industry, she really doesn't give a flip about things that are cosmetic many times. She looks at your heart and your soul, and that's what she built her company on, building the beauty of women, and now men, from the inside out. She would rather you accentuate what's beautiful about you by using just a touch here and a touch there, rather than painting inches of of war paint on your face to cover up what you may think are your flaws, because in Bobby Brown's world, no one has a flaw.
Take care of yourself. If you don't take care of yourself, no one else is going to. And be happy for where you are, not where you used to be.
You know how hard it is to get into the New Jersey Hall of Fame while part of the, yes, it is, the 2013 class, Bobby Brown. No, I'm not in, but Bobby Brown is in. How does it feel?
It feels really cool. Really cool. Like crazy. My dad thinks it's the coolest thing in the world.
It is cool. Did you ever think to yourself of all the things you've accomplished? Hey, the New Jersey Hall of Fame?
Me and Grover Cleveland, who knew?
Tom Kane, Joe Piscopo.
Right, Joe Piscopo, yeah.
Tell folks your Jersey roots, because everyone sees you as a national, international celebrity, but you're Jersey.
You know, when I first came to New Jersey many years ago, I slept at the Livingston Mall to get tickets to the Bruce Springsteen concert. True story.
You don't get more Jersey than that.
No, and then last year I spent the whole day with Bruce and Patty at the 12-12 concert, so, yeah.
You're a Jersey girl.
I'm a Jersey. I chose to be a Jersey girl. Yeah.
What do you love about the state, Bobby?
Well, I've always wanted to be Courtney Cox in that video, so what I love...
With Bruce.
Yeah, exactly. What I love about New Jersey is people are nice, people are normal, people have an edge, people are funny. I love everything about New Jersey.
I know Dion not only as a brilliant singer, who you just turn on the radio and there's always one of her songs being sung by her, and you know right away that it's Dionne Warwick. But I want you to know she also is a fabulous mother. She raised two sons by herself, and they are wonderful, outstanding citizens. I know her as a mother. I know her as a fabulous pinochle player. But I also know that Dionne has always been one that gives back. And sitting in her kitchen one day, she said, you know, we have to do something. We live out here. We're from the East Coast, but we want to do something out here. And we started an organization called Bravo, which basically we started it because of sickle cell anemia. We wanted to find a way to raise money and awareness of the disease. Little did we realize that a bigger disease was going to be part of our lives when AIDS happened. And let me tell you something, Dionne Warwick stood up and she did, that's what friends are for, and made the awareness of people who are suffering from AIDS become worldwide.
The extraordinary Dionne Warwick. How does it feel to be home in Newark?
Isn't it wonderful? It's absolutely sensational.
What does this city, what does this state mean to you?
Well, the state, of course. I was born and raised in East Orange, New Jersey. Went to school in East Orange. And it's home.
And your connection tonight. Tell everyone.
Well, the connection tonight I'm receiving. I'm being inducted into the New Jersey Hall of Fame. Yada, yada.
How does that feel?
Incredible. Absolutely incredible.
Who has had an impact on people he never will ever know. And because of him, they live and they flourish. Needless to say, we stand here, as was just said, in a few blocks from a wonderful art center in Newark that simply wouldn't be there if it hadn't been for Ray Chambers. There's so much that it wouldn't be if not for Ray Chambers. But most importantly, human beings are better people and have better lives, and their families and their children and their grandchildren and their great-grandchildren will have better lives because of Ray Chambers.
I'm currently the United Nations Secretary General's Special Envoy for Malaria, and our goal is to cover everybody at risk of malaria in Africa with bed nets by the end of this year. And over the last 7 years, we've raised $8 billion. We've covered 800 million people with these insecticide-treated mosquito nets. And the annual death rate has gone from 1.2 million to less than 500,000. I don't think that business is meant to be an end of itself, because it's the catalyst that raises the tide and all the other boats rise with that tide. But I think it's a means to an end. Do something good, feel something real.
One of the most extraordinary inductees in the 2013 class, a guy who teaches us all how important it is to give, Ray Chambers. Ray, you avoid honors like the plague, but this honor, being inducted into the Hall of Fame, what does it mean to you?
It's very special, Steve. As you know, having been born and having grown up in Newark.
West Side High?
West Side High School. Spent my whole life in New Jersey. I'm so glad that they decided to have a Hall of Fame, and so honored to be part of it and to be inducted with Joe Piscopo and Governor Kane and the other inductees.
Finally, let me ask you this. You travel all over the world. You work with the UN, and you see a lot of people, and you've been a lot of places. What is it about New Jersey?
I hadn't thought about that question until you just asked it, but my immediate response was the most giving, the most charitable people I've met anywhere.
A pure, sweet voice that could strike a chord deep into the hearts of audiences all over the world. The voice that always gave wings to the work of musicians and songwriters. She gave a bit of her very soul to every performance of word and emotion. You knew her as Whitney Houston, the icon. She was the woman with the voice in a different stratosphere. She was just simply the best. Received every award imaginable from all around the world. So I don't have to talk about the accolades and everything that she gained in the world. But at the foundation of Whitney's heart and soul were her family and her deepest love and faith in God. Over three decades, she gave you Newark, music, beauty. She represented you around the world very well. That little girl that was born in Newark, New Jersey, that went to school in New Jersey, had a child in New Jersey, got married in New Jersey. She represented you very, very well. And I am asking for her legacy. Whitney still lives, and the core of Whitney is right here because this is where her family is. This is the Garden State. She's laid to rest here, right here in New Jersey. Remember her. love her, continue to build her legacy, represent her the way she represented you.
Bittersweet memories, that is all I'm taking with me. So goodbye, please don't cry. We both know I'm not what you need. And I will always love you. I will always.
We are here with Sissy Houston, who is just a star, not just in Newark and not just in New Jersey, but everywhere. Tonight's a special night. Talk about why.
Yeah, very special why. My dad's getting inducted into the Hall of Fame. I sure wish she was here to receive it herself, but of course I'm very proud and very trying to get through it.
Yeah. Whitney, strong connection to Newark. Big connection to Newark, right? People don't realize that, to Newark and New Jersey.
She was born in New Jersey, yes. Went to school in New Jersey.
Well, you honor us, and I thank you, and wish you and your family nothing but the best.
Yeah, thank you so very much.
On behalf of everyone connected to the New Jersey Hall of Fame, I want to thank all of you for being with us tonight. The hour is late, but it was more than worth it. One more time for the 2013 inductees of the New Jersey Hall of Fame. Congratulations to all of you.
One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been a production of the Caucus Educational Corporation, celebrating 25 years of broadcast excellence. Funding for this edition of One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been provided by Barnabas Health, Cone Resnick, the New Jersey Education Association, PSE&G, Johnson & Johnson, Horizon Blue Cross Blue Shield of New Jersey, and by the Carpenter Contractor Trust, New York, New Jersey. Promotional support provided by the Star Ledger, powering NJ.com. Transportation provided by Airbrook Limousine, serving the metropolitan New York, New Jersey area. One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been produced in partnership with St. Joseph's Healthcare System.